I've had trouble sleeping because I've been afraid of the lack of control over myself I have when I am dreaming, and I have little control in the real world as well. I have let my life become the marionette of others. It has come to the point where the decisions of others will determine whatever future is there for me, and it's led to my distrust of many whom I meet. I'm not satisfied with what my life has become at this point, and I fear how it will evolve. My constant dreaming has distorted my vision of reality, making me more and more drained, creating a wrenching feeling in my stomach. This feeling is a reminder that I will most likely be alone for the rest of my days. I wish I could return to the past and fix all my mistakes and missed opportunities that I've come across throughout my years, only to restore the happiness I used to know. I wish I could. I wish I could.
So what? I told you I'd never want to see you here again.
I know you did, but can I just have my jacket?
No, don't make me call Johnny.
I don't care if he tries to kill me, it's my jacket.
It looks better on him.
You gave it to him. You know my aunt bought that for me?
Get out of here, just go.
You know what? Fine. Screw you and screw your boyfriend.
Just go!
I am!
Yeah.
Hey Marty, it's Dean.
Oh, hey man.
I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
No. Why? What's up?
Is it alright if I come over?
Now?
Yeah, I mean, are you busy?
No, of course not. You know, I haven't had anything going on for ages. Yeah, for sure, you can come.
Alright, great, I'll see you there.
So after the fight with Louise, I get in my car, and before I'm about to leave, I see this little girl. And she just runs into the street, and there was a car coming up.
So then she was just...
Yeah. I saw it all. Just the impacts, the car just didn't stop. And all that was left of the girl lying there was her blood painted on the asphalt.
So when did the ambulance get there?
About 3 minutes. Which was kind of fast, considering, I guess. But it wasn't fast enough. Just, I mean, she got hit by a freaking car. To tell you the truth, I didn't know if she was alive or dead. Just, they took her as quick as they could and they left.
You know what the worst part is? I could have stopped it.
Well, no. Come on, Dean, don't blame yourself for that.
But I was right there, and I saw the car coming, and I saw the little girl before she even got to run in the street.
But it wasn't in your power.
But what if it was? What if God had let this happen so I could be living a better life of heroism by preserving another? And I failed.
No, don't give me that God stuff. It wasn't God that put that girl in danger just so you could save her. It was that idiot driver who doesn't know that there are pedestrians present in a neighborhood.
And you know what? If there is a God helping us, why did he give us crap lives, huh?
Well, just like it was that driver's fault for endangering the girl's life, it's our own fault for our own lives, not God's.
You know, a lot of people live in worse conditions than us, and a lot of innocent people die for no reason. And yet, here we are, complaining about what's happening to us.
Yeah, our coworkers and bosses keep stepping on our balls for their own pleasure, and yeah, you had your nightmare with that waitress. What was her name? Amelie? I had mine with Louise. But who cares? They were horrible. We shouldn't let that bring us down.
Well, I don't have to deal with the god-awful people of the world anymore. Everything sucks because of them.
Yeah. Life sucks. But you know what? That's what makes it even more beautiful. You may not believe in God, but I do. And that, Marty, that is what gets me out of bed every morning. If the world was just one little utopia, that would sure as hell be dreadful. What happens nowadays is real, and the only way we can be better people is if we keep taking and taking that reality. Only until we finally rise up and take control of our own lives.
And you think, if we're only living to breathe for our own purposes,
let's just go out and help people who actually need it themselves, instead of just staying here where we're at. I mean, let's just be one of those people who work hard and make the world a better place. Yeah, life sucks, but our purpose is to make it suck less. And if we finally die, then we can be satisfied with what we've done and be proud of the work we've accomplished.
And when we finally die, we can die satisfied with what we've done and what we've become.
We're capable of so much, and yet so far we've done nothing. So let's do something. Tonight.
What?
Tonight. Let's go out and live. Let's party. Let's meet girls. Let's go wild. Remind ourselves what it feels like to be happy. You know? Tomorrow? You know what we'll do tomorrow? We'll go hiking. Like, find the beauty in this world. And after that, we'll screw our old jobs, we'll get better jobs, you know? Better ourselves off, and then after that, to top it all off, why don't we join an organization to help people instead of griping over our own lives?
You know what? That's a brilliant idea.
Yeah?
Yeah. Let's reclaim our existence.
Sweet. I just gotta go home, get ready, and I'll be back here by... 8?
Yeah, 8.
So I'll see you in a bit then?
Yeah, remember, 8 o'clock.
8 o'clock.